Hi, this is Rick Eimer, sports editor at the Palo Alto Weekly. We're here today with Cate Desler, the senior outside hitter for the Sacred Heart Prep volleyball team. She had 46 kills in two wins last week. They opened their league season. And one of his 29 kills. I'm pretty sure that's probably got to be one of your highest games, but we'll get to that. So she's our athlete of the week this week. And let's just talk about those two games last week to open the season.
It was a really great start to the season. Starting off with two wins for a league was really huge for us. But it's just the beginning. We're trying to go undefeated this year, but we have a lot of tough competition in league. So we'll see how it goes.
Yeah, the top three teams, what she mentions is the top three teams in this league last year were all in the Northern California playoffs, and one of them was a state champion. So we won't even mention that name on this in this video, though. So it is tough competition. And you also had some really good, tough preseason matches, too. So I think the only teams you've actually lost to that you haven't beaten are from the WCAL. So, I mean, that's saying something. I mean, is that good for you guys?
Well, obviously the goal is to win every game we play, but I guess we've lost to Carmont and Pally only. Carmont twice, actually. And those were both really great games. But, you know, it's when it's so close, you always think, like, oh, like, if only I did this one thing differently, like, we could have won. So, but both those teams are really, really good. And it was some great competition. It was really exciting to play some really great teams preseason.
Yeah, this area has really been good in volleyball for a long time. And that Carmont match, the last one, was the five-setter, right? You went to five sets with them right here, I think.
It was four sets.
Four sets? Oh, okay. But, I mean, they're a really good team, they're obviously undefeated in their league right now. So, let's talk about, you know, last year you guys did a really good job. You got to the NorCal semifinals and regional semifinals, and just one step away from that going to the state or going to the NorCal championship. Is that a motivator for you guys this year, or how do you use that?
Oh, it definitely is, because last year we were so close. We could just taste it. But unfortunately, we lost to a team we had beaten earlier in the season. So that was pretty hard for us to get over. But now it's a really good motivation to know that last year we made it that far, and this year we know we can make it that far and even further.
Right. Now, I know you not as many seniors this year as you had last year, but some very good, talented young players. And maybe talk about a couple of your teammates a little bit and how they've helped you.
Well, definitely all of our seniors were on the team last year, and really a core group are the four of us, and we really play great together. And it's also great how we blend with all the underclassmen. This year we have three sophomores and then six juniors. So next year that's going to be a huge senior leadership team. So that's good for the future. But this year we all blend so great together, and the team chemistry is always there. It's like a sisterhood.
Yeah, well, that's obviously what it takes. So, you know, it's very unique about Sacred Heart Prep is that a lot of the teams here are very closely, obviously because of the campus size, it's not as big, but still, that's quite a thing. You kind of play for each other a little more than you might at another school. And, you know, is there any way to kind of put that into words, that little, the bond?
Just a lot of my best friends are on this team, and everyone will do anything for each other. Like, no matter what, never be afraid to ask for anything. We know we'll always be there for each other, and everyone will always give 110%. Like, go all out for everything, because we all know we all want it as badly as everyone. So it's just, really, we all do it for each other.
Great. Hey, did you, I know you played club volleyball, I'm sure. How long have you been playing volleyball?
I think I first learned in fifth grade, but my first power league team was sixth grade.
Ah. And you on the team, any teams that went to the JOs or anything?
Yes. So for the past probably 4 years, I want to say, maybe five, I've gone to nationals, but for the past 2 years, I've been on the Vision team. So that's really been great. It's a lot of good girls there. So it makes me a lot better playing with a huge competition.
Yeah, not only that, but also against the best in the country, obviously. Yeah. And some of those are playing now, you know. So, I was just thinking about this. What makes this place so unique? I mean, I'm here standing in this, what I think is this idyllic situation here in the forest, and I pass some goats over there. And, you know, this is really a unique place.
It really feels like a campus, like away from everything else. I feel like when I'm at school, I feel like it's like just at school. It's just like the Sacred Heart community. Since we're such a small school too, the class sizes are really small. I'm friends with everyone in my class. Everyone knows each other's names. And just, yeah, everyone, like class sizes are small, so it's a lot of good collaboration. And it's just, I'm friends with like seniors, juniors, sophomores, freshmen. Like I know everyone here.
Yeah, great. And I'm sure it's an academically oriented school, whereas, you know, some public school or schools that I go to, I'll say that, you know, some of us were messing around too much. But anyway, this is Cate Desler. She's our Girls Athlete of the Week this week, and congratulations.
Thank you.
And if you'd like to find out who our next Athlete of the Week is, please press the subscription button down below or check us out on pasportsonline.com.